Hey, it's Colby with Colbus Photo, and I got another tip for you guys. So, you want to get married outside, right? Well, let me tell you how you can get the best shots possible. So, I've photographed a lot of weddings, and I have to say, outdoor ceremonies are some of the best that I've ever seen. There's just something about that nature with the connection of two people falling in love that just gives this serene feeling. I 100% will back anybody who says that they want to have an outdoor wedding, even here in Ohio. That said, though, there are a few things to consider when you're looking at outdoor ceremony spots. A lot of people will go and look at a location when their ceremony is in a totally different time of year, or they'll go and they'll look at it at a totally different time of day. And the sun is such an important factor for outdoor weddings that a lot of people don't think about. As a photographer, light is literally our lives. It shapes everything that happens. I have a light here, I have lights there. So light really changes the way an image looks and can make it look exceptional or make it look kind of dull. So I really want to stress to people to think about where the sun's going to be at. If you can, go out to your ceremony spot at the exact same time of year and the exact same time of day as you plan on getting married and have a look at it then. Not only that, really take some time to look at the background of the image too. Like, what is it going to look like behind you? Some people will look at a location and say, "Oh man, this is absolutely great." But then 3 months from now, maybe there's corn out there and it doesn't look the same as you thought it was going to look. So really take that into account. What I'm going to tell you is if you're standing holding hands with your significant other, think about where your guests are going to be sitting. And if they're going to be out here, that means your photographer more than likely is going to be out there as well. What I recommend is to have the sun coming at your officiant's back. Now, what that's going to do is it's going to put a small rim light around the back of you guys. So as you're looking out at your friends and your family and the photographer, that's going to put this nice glow of light all around the outside of you. And then not only that, you're not going to have these harsh, direct shadows like under your eyes and this harsh sunlight hitting you in the face, which causes people to squint and all sorts of different issues that just make it really a nightmare for us photographers. That said, if you find a location you absolutely love it, I tell you to go to it. Do what you want to do. This is your wedding day. I'm just giving you an example of something that might make your images turn out just a little bit better than you anticipated. So think about where you're going to be at that time of year and that time of day, and then think about what's going to be behind you. Because, you know, this is the first kiss. This is when you tell your significant other, "I do." This is a very important moment, and it's great to have the best photos that you can get of that moment. So take some time, talk with your photographer, and say, "Hey, this is what I had in mind. What do you think about it?" Again, this goes along with some earlier tips to get to know your photographer early on because they can give you vital information that can help you have the best shots that you could have ever dreamed of. Thanks for tuning in again to another tip from Colbus Photo. I hope to see you guys here in the next one. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me, and I'd be more than happy to answer them. Have a good one.